Welcome to Ralph's Fly Box. Today we're going to tie the RuffChuck. The RuffChuck is kind of a blend of the Gotcha Clouser, Crazy Charlie. It got its name from the materials used. I tied this fly originally as a trout fly. I fished it with a dropper and bottom bounced it. It did exceptionally well. I fished it across most of Pennsylvania for smallmouth as well, and it's done very well there. But it's still primarily a trout fly, tied in the size that I tied here. We're going to start with a Mustad Signature C67S, size 6. And I begin with 3/0 red tying thread. We begin by tying a base, primarily for the eye. And then next we're going to tie in tungsten dumbbell eyes, barbell eyes. I begin by figure eighting, wrap it in, and once it's secured, I give about a half dozen wraps directly under it and around it to seat it. That usually puts it in place. And we leave about an eye and a half. We leave a fairly large gap for the head. And then bring our thread back. Point, I'm going to adjust my hook a little bit. I adjust the hook with this pattern a couple times. And I'm going to bring it back to right about even with the point of the barb. And the first material we're going to use is the barred marabou rump feathers, the dun and cream tip marabou rump feathers from a ruffed grouse. They're a straggly. Usually they're straggly, they're matted a little bit when you get the skins for the rough grouse. Now you got to pick through them. Usually you'll end up with a good 30 to 40 usable with each skin. You can substitute. I've used Brahma as well, but this pattern began with this marabou because of the color and the barring that it has in the action. And we begin by sweeping the fibers to the rear, and I tie the marabou, I measure the marabou hook length, eye to bend, okay? And then I tie that hook length in at the point of the barb. That's going to give us our length as well for the next portion of the wing. Clip that off and bind it down. Next, we're going to dub our abdomen. I use ginger or gold ice dub. And you're going to build this body up a little bit, so you're going to use quite a bit of this material. This is a fairly simple fly to tie. There's a few steps with this type of hook that I have to manipulate the hook. And you have to manipulate the material, and you'll see as we go forward. You're going to build a slightly tapered body. Not too crazy. But you want it to taper towards the eyes, get a little bit larger. I've tied this as well with peach and gold estas for the body. And While it has worked, it hasn't worked as well for me. But for simplicity, that is an option. Build a slight taper, and then give just a couple wraps. I usually do a quick S wrap or X wrap between the eyes just to give something to cover them up. At this point, I flip my fly over. With this short shanked fly, this is the part that can get a little bit awkward. We're going to tie in our top wing. Which is RuffChuck. And generally, RuffChuck will give you about the right amount. And the right length material for tying this fly in this size. And that's how this pattern with this size hook and this hook came about. The materials just went together very well. When I go larger, I tend to use bucktail instead of substitute bucktail just because you need it to get a little bit longer. Now, to get out of the way of the hook, I've tied this pattern the same way. I start with the material across the shank of the hook. It's hard to see if it was this way, but it doesn't wrap as well if I put it this way. But I cross over the head, but I do it back towards me to keep the material from rolling and the thread from rolling. And you'll see it better as I give two or three security wraps. And then I bring the material forward and I split the hook with it and I pull it tight. Once I have that done, I pull the winging back until it's underneath the eye. Now you'll get some loss here. That's why I tie it just a slight bit larger than normal, but I tie it in with the tips extended or the butts extended, secure it, and then pull the wing into place, and that helps me manipulate the short shank and that hook point. I'm gonna trim off the few flyers that I have, the remaining butt section, and then wrap down securely. You're going to build a decent size head here. It's a substantial head that's part of the fly. You want that red to show. And then you're going to whip finish. And that evens, you'll notice, that evens the tail. It blends the white tip of the RuffChuck with the white tips of the rough grouse marabou tips. And then once I have this done, I place it back in the vise this way just because it's easier for me to manage the... And you're going to coat the head. I give two liberal coats of Sally Hansen's to get a good glossy head. Coat it well. It can soak in. I generally lift it and let the Sally Hansen's settle down towards the eye, like this. And then once that's dry, I'll put one more coat on for a good, heavy, high gloss head in red. And that does it. And there it is, the RuffChuck. Excellent trout pattern. A wonderful crossover pattern to smallmouth and warm water. It drifts under an indicator. It bottom bounces as a clouser. It's easily replicated in larger patterns with different material to fish saltwater as well. But it has performed exceptional for me as a trout pattern. Hope it adds to your box. See you on the water. Thank you.